Today, I'm going to discuss with you about the rating of MCB used for motor. Here, I just wanna give you a thumb rule that the engineers followed in industries. I am an electrical engineer. To learn about this, please don't skip this video till its last. Thumb rule number one is, if your motor's capacity is less than or equal to 20 kilowatt, then you must choose the C-type MCB. We know that most of the motors are rated in HP, not in kilowatt. So first you need to convert this HP to the kilowatt. And if this kilowatt is less than or equal to 20, then you need to select the C-type MCB for your purpose. For to select an MCB, first you need to find the current for the motor. If it is the three-phase motor, then you use this equation. If it is single-phase motor, then you need to avoid this root 3 and find the current and then select a suitable MCB with a C-type. This C-type MCB will allow 5 to 10 times of the rated current for a short time, maybe for 1-3 seconds, just like that. Do you know why the engineers always choose the C-type MCB for the motors less than or equal to 20 kilowatt? Because they know very well that the motor in this capacity will take only the 5 to 10 times of the rated current during the starting of the motor. The engineers who works in the industry have much experience. That's why they use this method. And the thumb rule number two is, if the motor's capacity is greater than 20 kilowatt, then you must choose a D-type MCB. We know that D-type MCB will allow 10 to 20 times of the rated current for a short duration of time during the starting of the motor. Generally, we know that during the starting of motor, even if the motor is starting with the help of a DOL starter, it would take 8 times of the rated current. Even though engineers follows this method for the extra safety and to avoid the nuisance stripping of the MCB. The method that I have discussed here, you can't see in any books. You know, 80% of the loads in an industry is motors. So the industrial engineers are very well experienced with how to deal the motors and the MCB and that type of things. So it will be very useful for you. I hope you have got much knowledge through this video. If so, please like this. And if you want to get more videos with lot of information like this, please consider to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.